so, man. Tell me about yourself.
All right, I'm Joseph Fannin Sr., and the two cars behind me are 1929 Model A Fords. The sedan is my father's car, which we started restoring back in the 1960s. He passed before we could get it restored, so I finished the project. Took me 15 years, and it's won 9 best of shows now in a row in the last year. It's a 29 Model A Ford sedan Murray 155A body. And the pickup I just obtained from a gentleman in Alabama, it's a 29. It's already been restored back in 93. A doctor bought it from a guy in Arizona. It was originally a flower delivery car truck back in 1929, 30, 31. And then it was out in Arizona in a barn, and the doctor bought it in Atlanta, restored it. A gentleman in Alabama bought it from him, showed it a couple times in parades. And then I just purchased it from him just recently. Now the 1974 Volkswagen I just obtained from a job site that I was working on, a 1910s house that I restored and did the architectural drawings for. And I got the Doodlebug, did some mechanical work on it. She's ready to go. All three vehicles are drivable, showable cars.
And tell me, how many hours have you spent on these cars?
All right, on the 29 sedan, which is the family car, I have probably 60 hours just on getting the body back on the frame and aligning the doors. Probably all together by putting the car back original like my parents wanted it, took me probably 2,000 or 3,000 hours, easy. And then on the pickup, it was already restored. I just went and got it. Took me 2.5 days to get it home. And then the Volkswagen, I've probably got 400 or 500 hours in mechanical work on it to get it up to snuff and backing up and running. Most of it had already been restored by another party, and they're all three showable cars now.
Oh man, tell me how you worked on these cars and what you play a role in.
My name's Paul, and these vehicles belong to my brother-in-law, Joe Fannin. And what I did to them was, since he got them, I just thoroughly cleaned the outside with a lot of soap and water, both vehicles, and the inside. It's all original, and all I did was put on like maybe a couple coats of wax. Old time Mother's California beeswax, and then the modern spray wax that I put on seems to hold up better and has more shine.
A basket full of chicken and a big cold jug of sweet tea. Well, I make a little room and she climbs on up. I open up a throttle and stir a little dust. Just look at her face, she ain't a fooling me. She thinks my tractor's sexy, it really turns her on. She's always staring at me while I'm chugging along. She likes the way it's pulling while we're tilling up the land. She's even kind of crazy about my farmer's tan. She's the only one who really understands what gets me. She thinks my tractor's sexy. Get to the barn, put it up for the night. Climb up in the loft, sit and talk with the radio.
So you say you have to screw these together, yeah, in order for the fan to work?
Yeah.
What year is this?
1923, November 6th, this bottle was made in Tallahassee, Florida.
Coca-Cola had a fishing rod.
They got their name on everything. This is a what they call a draw knife. They would shave the bark, the pine bark and the bark off of trees before they put them into the old mills and sawed them up into boards. Package driver at one time. And then I went into semis. In the front room, I got my semi. All the saws in here are my grandfather's collection, but this particular one he used him and my grandmother to saw their firewood, and they sold firewood too. It was passed down to my dad, and it's passed down to me, and it will be passed to my grandsons and further down. Lord setting, you know?
Mm-hmm.
We got that in Israel. That's made out of olive wood. That was made back in the 50s. Actually, this is a serving tray, and a piece of glass goes here, and you would serve on the table.
Did you ever take it straight up?
What's your thing about this Volkswagen?
What's the...
Your favorite.
What's your favorite thing about this car?
When it first came out, I guess people were bragging that it was getting 20 miles to a gallon. If it was true or not, I don't know. But that's back in the 60s or 70s when gas was only like 65 cents a gallon. Today, it's $5, $6 a gallon. It's incredible how it keeps its stability. There's got to be a gyro on there.
Teaching my man how to work the drums. So how you feel about drones?
Actually, no matter what you do, especially in reverse, you could only, it only goes so far.
Yeah, yeah, and he loved me.